Hey everyone, welcome to or welcome back to my channel. My name is Chrissy. I'm also known on Instagram as MakeupRebel89. You can subscribe, follow, leave a comment, ring the bell, ding ding, all that good stuff. Today I'm going to be using the Jaclyn Hill Bling Boss palette. This is what it looks like on the inside. But today I'm not really going to be talking about the makeup all that much. I kind of wanted to tell you guys some stories about my childhood, you know? Get to know me, get to know who I was before the makeup and all that. Alrighty, so let's get into it. So, since today isn't really about the makeup, I will try and make sure that I hold the products up. If I forget, I'm sorry, but all of them will be linked down in the description box. So, I really wanted to tell you guys the story about the what happened to my eyebrow. I told you guys that I have a scar in one of my other videos on this eyebrow, and that's why I never really went into the trend of the really thin eyebrows, because I have had a scar on my eyebrow since I was really young. But I also wanted to give some, you know, before I tell that story, go into kind of what we did when I was younger. So we lived in apartments, but in these apartments it was backed up against this really wooded area. I grew up in Portland, Oregon. And so we had these really huge, big trees and forest-like stuff behind us. And the forest was actually on the houses up on the hill, their property. So technically, we were actually trespassing. Which, you know, they didn't get too upset. Like, you know, we were kids, we were just playing around, hanging out. And as long as we, you know, didn't get hurt or anything like that, they were perfectly fine with us playing up there. But my dad managed these apartments that we were living in. So he had these storage sheds full of wood and you know, materials to help fix the apartments and whatnot. So we would take those materials, like wood and whatnot, and we would go into this forest and we would build these huge, extravagant forts. I remember we had this one fort that was like 3 stories tall, and it had this ladder that you would climb that was connected to the tree, and then we hung a rope from one tree to another tree that we would make like a zip line, and we'd have like this canvas that we'd hold on to and slide down this zip line. Super cool. We were very, very ingenuitive kids. But underneath, we would, on the other end, we put these mattresses that we found in the dumpster and put them underneath, so that way if we fell, at least we were falling on something cushy. So, like I said, very ingenuitive kids. So with these forts, we would all get together and we would play war games. We would create teams and we'd fill grocery bags with sand and dirt and things like that. We had forts that were underground. We had smaller forts. Just all this stuff. And we would play these kind of, you know, little games that we would be against each other. And we'd all be on these teams. And one would have one fort and one would have another. And then we each would create flags. And whichever team took the flag and brought it back to their home fort would win. So that is kind of what we did growing up. So this one kid, and I don't mind saying his name, like, we were 10, and I think the oldest one in our group was maybe 15, 16. So his dad had this airsoft BB gun. And his dad had told him, like, you know, we don't take this out of the house. Like, we take it when we go hunting, you know, for you to shoot. Because obviously his dad had, you know, other guns and whatnot for himself. And then this was this kid's gun for when they, like, went out of town and all that. So, well, he didn't listen to his dad. He brought it out and brought it to the fort, and we set up these cans, and we all were, you know, just hitting these, like, target practice, you know? Well, my smart aleck mouth, he wasn't hitting the cans, and so I was like, oh, he can't shoot, he can't shoot, he can't shoot, he can't aim, look at him, all that, just being a little smart out child. Sorry about that. My kids have a snow day today and they wanted a snack. Where was I? Oh yeah, being a smart aleck kid. So, I'm this smart aleck kid, running my mouth, and he takes the BB gun, points it in my face, and pulls the trigger. So, this BB gun hits me in the eye. Thank God, not like in my eye. I had closed my eye. But, the BB gun went into my, like, right here on my eye, right into my brow, and I was a tomboy, and I'm like, he's not gonna see me cry. And I got super angry and a vindictive little kid. I took the gun from him. And I chased him all the way home, shooting him in the butt. Granted, he had pants on and everything like that. But when we get to his house, his dad was just getting home and saw me chasing him with this BB gun that, you know, his son is not supposed to have. And his son knows, you know, that, you know, he's not supposed to have it. And the dad freaks out, flips out, and starts yelling at me, saying, How did you get this? Where did you get this? Because he could see, you know, he knew which brand and what style, you know, he had. And he's like, where did you get this? Where did you get this? And then his son comes running up and is like, she took it out of the house. She took it out of the house. And I had never even been in their house before. And this dad just turns and starts yelling at me. And I mean yelling, like, how dare you come in my house and you think it's okay to take things? And I'm just standing there like I hadn't ever been yelled at like that before. And I didn't know exactly what to do. And then finally, words came out of my mouth. Finally. And I'm like, I didn't do it. He shot me. He shot me. And so I took it and I shot him back. You know, whiny little brat child. And then the dad took a pause and he saw, like, the blood, you know, streaming down my face because the head bleeds like crazy. And he's like, oh my gosh. And then the son was like, I only shot her once. And then he pulls down the back of his pants and is like, she shot me a whole bunch of times. And the son, I mean, his butt was bruised. Little pellet BBs all over his bottom. And the dad's like, well, if you hadn't ever taken the gun out of the house, she never would have had access to it, and you never would have shot her in the eye, and she would have never shot you in the butt. And he takes his son in the house, and I hear them yelling, and I'm like, oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, what is my dad gonna do, you know? And, because my dad's the apartment manager, everybody knew me, you know? The dad then, obviously, because I'm bleeding, and I didn't even realize how bad it was until, you know, I had stopped and my adrenaline had stopped and everything like that. The dad walked me home and after, of course, taking his son inside and yelling at him and all that, walked me home and explained to my dad what had happened. And apologized profusely, and the whole time my dad is scowling at me. Like, I knew that once this guy leaves, I am in a world of hurt. But my dad, you know when you know. You know when your parents are mad or disappointed or not having it. That was my dad. I knew. And boy howdy, when that guy left, I can't even remember his dad's name. I remember the kid's name. I don't remember the dad's name. My dad reamed my butt. He was like, how dare you think. Because my dad had been in law enforcement. We knew about guns and knew that we shouldn't be playing with them and all that. But when you're 10 and everyone else is playing with them, all that kind of goes out the window. You're like, oh, this is so cool. Anyway, that's how I got the huge scar in my eyebrow. Is I was a stupid kid and egged on this kid that had a BB gun and got shot in the eye. But after that, my dad brought out his, you know, weapon and explained all the horrible things that could have happened if that gun had not been just a regular airsoft gun. Had it been something more like a true, you know, firearm. And so ever since then, I was very, you know, very much more careful and didn't do stupid things like that. But, and then, oh, another time, this one y'all will think is seriously so, so stupid. My brother, who is quite a bit older than me, he was born in 69 and I'm born in 89, so he's about 20 years older than me. I stayed home from school sick. Obviously faking, because when I was younger, I did not like school. I didn't apply myself when I was younger, and so I just didn't do well. So my brother was taking care of me, watching me while my parents were at work. And he was cutting stuff up or making something, and I, a little dum-dum, was like, oh yeah, sword fight. And I grabbed a little butter knife, and my brother grabbed a butter knife, and we were playing pirates and clanking them around, being weirdos in the kitchen while he was making me probably some kind of sandwich or something. And I had this, you know, like, t-shirt on or whatever. He scrapes the butter knife on my arm, and obviously not thinking that it would cut me, like, it's a butter knife. Nope. He was wrong. We were both wrong. A butter knife can cut you. And I had a huge gash in my arm. I think he didn't realize how hard he had scraped my arm. And it bled like a sieve, of course. Like everything, bleeds like a sieve. And so I have, still to this day, it's very faint now. It used to be quite a bit bigger. But I have a butter knife scar on my arm. So, my sister, though, is the worst one. She has some horrible stories of getting hurt. It's like any time she stepped outside, she was getting hurt. It, like, no fail, she's getting hurt. Like, don't even bother going outside because you're gonna get hurt. Those forts that we would make, she was the one person that we were building a fort, and she, I'm just taking a little bit of black shadow to, out of the original Jaclyn Hill palette, just to deepen this up. I got a little bit, the shadow got a little bit away from me, to be perfectly honest. Anyway, we were building this fort, and there was nails in this piece of wood. And she didn't realize and fell on them. Fell on the pieces of wood with the nails. And the nails went straight through her hand. And I was surprised. It was not bleeding that much. It literally, I was like, why isn't there, you know, any blood, you know? So she's crying hysterically. And I don't know what to do. And so I run and go grab an adult that lived nearby that, you know, and he comes and he picks her up and takes her to our house, our apartment where my parents are at. And my parents were immediately like, what were you guys doing? Where were you guys at? And by this time, we had been told a few times, like, there's no supervision up in that forest. You guys don't need to be playing up there, but we were doing it anyway. So I didn't want to tell my parents, of course, because I didn't want to get in trouble, that we disobeyed them and that we were playing exactly where they told us not to be playing. So my parents did find out, obviously, because I had to tell them that we were up in the forest playing, building a fort, and Katie had, you know, obviously gotten nails in her hands because we were doing something that we weren't supposed to be doing in the first place. My mom ends up taking my sister to the emergency room because she still has these nails. So my mom ends up taking my sister to the emergency room. My sister ends up having to get a tetanus shot. Of course, they were rusty nails. And I end up grounded because I was the older sibling and I should have not have, I should have known not to play up there. That I should have respected my parents and listened. So yeah, that was a fun time. Oh, another time is my So we went to a birthday party for this kid we knew, and he was quite a bit younger than us. We were probably, I think I was probably 15, so my sister was probably 13, maybe 12. But this little kid, for his birthday, got this little 50 dirt bike. If you don't know what a 50 is, it's just the size of the motor. It's like a mini bike. And she's like, I want to ride it. And so I tell her, you know, because I've ridden bikes before, because obviously I'm the tomboy. She is very much the girly girl. I was like, you pull in the clutch and you go through the gears. And I showed her how to go through the gears on the bike, and I showed her what neutral was, and first gear, and then how to push in the clutch and push on the brake, so that way the bike obviously comes to a stop. Well, she gets on the bike, and apparently this whole learning, you know, thing that I walked her through of pushing the clutch, so that way the bike's, you know, slows down, and then grab the brake, or just completely let go and the bike will stop. She completely forgot it. Well, she's riding it in this person's backyard, and completely blows through their fence with this dirt bike. On this kid's brand new little dirt bike that he got for his birthday. But not only did she not know how to stop it, but on top of that, she's still holding on as she goes through the fence, not even on the seat anymore. She literally is straddling the rear wheel at full power, and the rear wheel is spinning, completely ripping through her jeans. Oh man. So funny. So anyway, the fence ends up stopping her, and she's caught in the fence. And the bike wasn't broken, so, you know, all is well that ends well. And then I was probably another one. I was probably 17, My sister was probably 15. She hadn't gotten her driving permit yet. And I had an 80, a little 80 motorcycle, dirt bike. And then I had a 125, and then I had a 250. The 250 was my brother's, and we would take them out riding, and my sister, we tried taking her out to try and teach her again how to ride. And at this place, we had to go under these railroad ties. They're so, they're like two metal posts and then a metal connector, almost like a railroad crossing, kind of looking like that, right? And we just roll our bikes underneath them and go ride our dirt bikes. In this field by these railroad tracks. There was a bunch of like hills and cool jumps and things like that out there. It was a really great place to ride. But my sister wanted to go, and I was like, yeah, okay, I'll take you. And, you know, again, I teach her how to, you know, stop the bike, and I make sure that she's on the little 80s, so that way, if nothing else, she can just keep her hands off of everything and put her feet down. And I tell her, if you get scared or you get to a place where, you know, you're confused and you don't remember what you're doing, or you don't remember how to shift or something like that, literally just take your hands off the handlebars and stand up. Like, that's all you gotta do. Nothing special. You just let the bike fall to the ground. It's not that big a deal. It's just a dirt bike. So we're out there. I get past the railroad ties with her and, you know, showing her how to do this. And she was excited. She was doing okay for a minute, and then I don't know what went through her brain, and like, I was making sure that she was away from the railroad ties, because obviously they're metal, and you don't want to hit them or anything like that. But I was telling her to get ready to, I was motioning to her to get ready and come in, that we were, you know, gonna pack up and head out. And she wasn't riding too long, but we, I don't know, for some reason we had to leave or something. This story is getting long, isn't it? So she comes in and she's riding the bike, and somehow, apparently, forgets how to stop. And I don't know how she forgets how to stop. She literally was doing it. Deanie, can you go play with that in the bedroom? Good. Thank you. So I motioned for her to come in, and she's coming in. And I can tell she was coming in way too fast. And I'm like, you know, slow down, slow down. And I'm not yelling at her. I'm just like, hey, you need a, you know, just like this. Like, whoa, whoa. Well, she ends up. Strolling in too fast, and she's getting super close to the railroad ties, and at this point I'm like screaming at her. I'm like, let go, let go, let go, you know, just, she's going to, you know, get decapitated by this damn railroad tie. So literally 2 seconds before she gets decapitated, she lets go. The bike just whoosh right under the railroad tie, hits my truck, bounces off the truck. Oh, it was wild. Anyway, she has not ridden a bike since then. She also does not know how to drive a manual transmission vehicle because it's the same aspect as a motorcycle or a dirt bike. Okay, one more story as I finish up my makeup. So, when I was about 16, I went to Las Vegas for the summer and went with my aunt and worked at the Macy's in Las Vegas. But before I came home, I went to this fireworks stand, right? And I bought these 3 fireworks that had the name, they're called flaming balls. And I'm like, oh, that'll be cool. Like, I'll take them home. I'll do them with my family at home, you know. So I put them in my bag and I fly home, which, please, no one fly with fireworks in their bag. That's stupid. Okay? But they did not get found. Which I find is crazy because this was after the whole 9/11 thing. I think. Yeah. It was after. So I take these fireworks home, and I did not know when I bought them that they were mortar fireworks that you put in the cylinder and they blast up into the air. And so I was like, okay, like, no big deal, like, I'll just light these fireworks, you know, with all my family, and, you know, we'll just have some fun and light fireworks and enjoy our 4th of July. My mom's birthday, by the way, is the 3rd of July. So we usually kind of, you know, do family stuff and hang out for her birthday. So, at our house that we had, across the street was this big parking lot. And it had a business that was restoring TVs, like putting new tubes, and you know, you could drop off your old TV and they would, you know, fix it up and sell it or whatnot. Well, they were closed, obviously. I didn't do it while they were open. And I did this on the actual 4th of July. It wasn't like a day before or the day after. It was on the actual 4th of July. And my brother was there, my dad was there. We were all hanging out. My grandma lived as, she was our next door neighbor, literally right next door. And then my great aunt was like just down the street, like not very far at all. This is just not working. Okay, so back to these fireworks. So I had these fireworks called flaming balls, and they didn't have any instructions on them. I literally bought them from like this rinky-dink, you know, stand in Las Vegas. Nothing special, just this. It wasn't like a... It was more like a family thing rather than like those TNT ones or whatever that you buy like the regular normal fireworks from. So everyone's got their chairs. They're out there waiting for me to set out these fireworks. We also had like the little poppets and whatnot. So I go across the street because I thought this is probably going to be better if I, you know, everyone's going to see them better. If I light them, you know, across the street, everyone's going to, you know, they're going to go up in the air and, you know, everyone's going, woohoo, those are awesome, kind of thing. Well, I light them and the... The little fuse, right? That's on these starts, I mean, just like going, and it's spinning around, and I'm like, shoot, man, these are crazy, like these are some wild fireworks. And then it gets closer to the end, and the whole entire firework is just doing this big ass spin. And I'm like, oh my gosh, like, where does this friggin' firework think it think it's going, you know? Then, these flaming balls explode out of this firework. And if you have ever watched, like, Die Hard or any movie with a big scene in it with an explosion, that's it. That was these fireworks. It was literally like someone was like, we're gonna put a bomb inside this firework, and it's literally going to look like you are running away from an exploding building. Anyway, so I'm literally running from this explosion like this. Oh my God! Ah. Right? Because literally, explosion! Oh my gosh. So, let me tell you guys, do not underestimate fireworks. They can have some kick. It was intense. So I'm just brushing off this baking powder. Powder underneath my eye. I'm going to set my face. I'm trying to think of another story that I can tell you guys while I'm doing my lower lash line. I feel like this video is, like, never ending now. Shoot. What is another story? What is another story? Go to the bedroom. Sorry guys, my kids are home from school. They have a snow day today. Crap, you guys. I'm having such a hard time of thinking of another story to tell you. I'm taking Spark. And putting it on my lower lash line. I have to say, I don't think this Bling Boss palette is as good as the Armand and Gorgeous one. I think the Armand and Gorgeous one is easier to use. I find it easier to use. I'm just blending the shimmery shade with some of the mystic shade, so that way it doesn't look so, like, just one line in the middle of my eye. Shoot, guys, I'm sorry, I can't think of any more stories. It's hard on the spot. I'm just going to use the ColourPop highlight. That's what it is, highlight.
Can we do it in a little bit?
Maybe in a little bit. Why don't you go play in your room? Here, you want to come say hi to the camera? This is Preston.
Hey.
Say hi. Lift you up a little bit here.
Yeah, it's in the mirror like me.
Yep. Okay, look at the camera and say hi.
Hi, guys.
All right.
Mommy's doing the disc in a little bit for playing our game. Mommy, this game is hard to play.
All right, baby. Give me a kiss.
Whoa.
Mwah. All right, go play in your room.
Okay.
So that's my oldest one, and he's in kindergarten, and they had a snow day today. So I'm just going to put a little bit on my nose bridge, a little bit on my nose. On the chin. Oh, that is a lot. There we go. All right. We got lips and then we're done. So I'm just going to outline my lips with the ColourPop BFF liner. That was my dad. He just walked by. She's at work. Alrighty. And I can't tell you the brand of this, but I can tell you it's Oh Wait Faded. That's the name of it. I'm just gonna throw a little bit of this on. And then I'm gonna throw a little bit of the Wet n Wild liquid catsuit on in the middle, of course, like always. And that's it, guys. We're done. Try and show you a close-up of what we did. Thank y'all for watching. If you would like to comment, subscribe, all that good stuff, I'm also on Instagram. You can follow me there. Thank you much for watching. Have a great day. Bye.